clock of every man. For at this time, most of us can be found at home, comfortable, knowing tomorrow is right on its way. At the 11th hour, most of us can be found in our beds. But in another world, our men and our women, our brothers and our sisters live in this hour. Tick, 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 tick. Every second for you, every second for me. So it was on the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month of 1918. The guns were lowered. The trenches grew silent. And an armistice was declared between the Allied nations and Germany. The Great War hushed so that the wives, the children, the fathers and the mothers could salute back across the ocean. And it is on this day each year that we have stopped to salute our veterans, our men and women of the 11th hour. So today, it's our turn. It's our turn to show our gratitude. It's our turn to applaud when they stand. It's our turn to thank God for you. Yes, it's our turn to say thank you for going in our stead.
Those who are presently serving, those who have served, we just want to say to you that we really are grateful to you for the time that you gave. And I know that there are some of you, many of you I've talked to and said, well, I didn't really do anything. And I think probably you mean that you weren't in combat. But whatever you did, we really appreciate it. We appreciate you serving. How many of you that are in the military, how many of you know your branch song? Anchors Away, you know, all the others, the Marine hymn and so forth. I had to actually tell one of the guys this morning in the first service, I said, that's your song. Get up there. Oh, so I hope that you know your song, but you should be able to recognize what's going on up on the screens. But what I'd like you to do, and many of you know you've done this before, is whenever you hear your song, I want you to come up and stand across the front here, and we're going to have a time of prayer for you and show you our gratitude. Okay? So let's go ahead and start, if we can. And we can. Go ahead. Okay, that's Navy. I'll call them out. We'll be right back. Go ahead and have a seat for a few moments, and we'll take up right where you left off in just a minute, okay? Go ahead and have a seat. Not you, folks, but we just wanted to say to you how much we appreciate the time that you gave in the military. Some of you, it's been a couple days ago, right? Way a couple days ago. And some of you, I don't know if you're any of you presently serving. Yeah, we have any down that way? Okay, but we really do appreciate what you did and the time that you served. No matter what you did, some of you served in combat. We thank you for that. And I'll be honest, there's no way we could know what you went through and what you saw, things you had to do. We don't know, nor do we understand that. But we thank you for your time. And we thank you for what you did. Thank you for following orders. And thank you for being a part of protecting and defending freedom, not only for this country, but for other people. You know, that is entirely scriptural, that we defend the liberty and come in and rescue people. I know in one of my many talks with Brother Benga, he told me that one of the reasons why he chose the United States to move to, he's from Nigeria, and there was a few nations that he was thinking about coming to, and one of the reasons why he came to this nation is because we help out the nations who can't help themselves and who are in distress. And I know that that's not with him alone. I know there are many like that, and I really do appreciate that. And we all do appreciate that, and we thank you for that. You are among those who fought for and stood for. Maybe you didn't fight for, except you might have fought through boot camp and so forth. you are among those who fought for our freedom to preach the gospel, to be able to read the Bible and to have a Bible even without it. You know, we can take our Bibles anywhere and not have to worry about anything but maybe some odd looks, you know, that we get. But that's okay. We can stand here and we can worship God. We can make as much noise as we want to in worshiping our God. No one's going to come in the door and tell us, you know, we're all arrested for doing that. And that's because of you. And because of you standing, and I know you're tired of standing there and you want me to shut up and let you be seated, right? But that's one of the other comments I make. But it's just once a year or so. You're good. But anyhow, we really do appreciate that. No matter what you did, if you were a cook or if you were in combat or anything in between there, we appreciate it. And to all of you, do you really enjoy your freedom to own property? You enjoy freedom to worship the way that you want to? You enjoy the freedom to go to whatever college or school that you want to? You enjoy the freedom of being able to, if you want to leave the United States and go somewhere, you know, the Bahamas or England or wherever you want to go, you're free to go, right? That's not true of a lot of nations. You just can't get out. It's the only nation I know of for sure that people are wanting to get in. They're not, you know, they're not anxious to leave. Well, these folks here are among the many who fought for and stood for those freedoms to give you. So can we thank them? Let's stand up and just give them applause. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Jason. Thank you, Jonah. Thank you, brother. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you, brother. Thank you, Don. Thank you so much. Thank you, Bob. Thank you. Thank you, man. Appreciate it. Thank you. Dismissed. You can go ahead and have a seat. Thank you so much. Go ahead and have a seat, folks. I've put together a program to show a lot of these people when they could actually fit into their uniforms. It's all right. I can't fit into any of the clothes I wore when I was that age either. So, one of these uniforms up here over on the left side, you noticed that when we played the Coast Guard hymn, we didn't have anybody stand up this time. That's because our brother Gene Borgman is in Alverno. He really would love to be here. But his uniform is here. That's his on the left side there. And somebody actually wore that. He wore it. It's about this big around in the waist. I think I might be able to get a leg in there, perhaps. But we're going to enjoy this. Pictures of those who are coming and attending the church here and those who we have a connection to through our relatives. I want you to pay particular attention to the songs and the words of the songs. They have an important message. Let's show this.
What this dying world could use is a willing man of God who dares to go against the grain and work without applause.
The man who raised the shield of faith, protecting what is pure, whose love is tough and gentle, a man whose word is sure. God doesn't need an orator who knows just what to say. He doesn't need authorities to reason him away.
He doesn't need an army to guarantee a win. He just needs a few good men.
Men full of compassion, who laugh and love and cry. Men who face eternity and aren't afraid to die. Men who fight for freedom and honor once again. He just needs a few good.
Broken derelict whose life has been renewed.
He calls the one who has the strength to stand up for the truth.
Enlistment lines are open and he wants you to come in. He just needs a few good men.
Eternity and aren't afraid to die. things. Give heart and soul and mind and strength to serve the King of Kings.
Rise up, O men of God, His kingdom tarries long. Bring in the day of brotherhood and in the night of wrong.
Under institutions. If this is a reality, then where are the solutions? A place where we can stand and sing the worship of our risen King without regret or shame. The hope for life eternally, we hold a light for all to see without a guilt or blame. It's what we claim. Oh, this is freedom.
Without number, line the fields of peace, and each one a silent witness staring back at me. And every cross a story of another place and time, where young men thought it worthy to give their life for mine. And for the sake of honor, left their dreams behind. For the price they pay, I'm forever in their debt. Their memory will not die, 'cause I will not forget.
I will stand and hold my head up high. I will dedicate my life to the glory of the ones who had to die. I will live, live what I believe. If I'm no one else but me,
to remember the freedom's never free. On another hillside, just outside the city gates, the battle lines were drawn as soldiers took their place. The father watched in silence as a cross was raised. The freedom drawn closer, he took his final breath. He drank a cup of guilt and took the sting from death. Heaven's finest soldier clothed in human flesh. For the price he paid, I'm forever in his debt. The cross will never die, 'cause I will not forget.
I will stand and hold my head up high. I will dedicate my life to the glory of the one who had to die. I will live, live what I believe. If I'm no one else but me,
to remember freedom's never free. I will walk free, I will stay free, I will live free.
America, land that I love, stand beside her and guide her through the night with a light from above, from the mountains to the prairies, to the oceans white with
again, God bless you, all of you veterans. By the way, there's nothing wrong with your hearing aid. That was just bad, the audio on that. I don't know. I'm really looking forward to when everything goes computers, aren't you? Tell you. A really nice version of that will be on our website, okay? If you'd like to see that later on, we'll get it up there later this week probably. We're going to receive an offering at this time, a regular tithe and offering. And I want to also have a time of prayer for our nation and for our veterans. As we give in the offering today, what we normally do, and we will do it again today, is in honor of all of our veterans, we're going to offer you to be able to give to buy Bibles for those who are presently serving in our military. And we go through a company called Biblica. If you want to look at their website, you can do that. They also have a version of the Bible where there are a lot of notes and different things for those who are struggling with PTSD, and you can get that Bible through them. But we found that the best way to get Bibles to the people in our military is to do it through the military chaplains. And so that's what we do. And in the past, we've been able to buy hundreds of Bibles for those who are serving. And the Bible, that's the Word of God, is powerful, is strong, and many people have come to the Lord just because a Bible has been placed in a certain place, in a motel room or in a military, given to them, and they've read it and know that there is a God, an awesome God, who loves them. And so that's the opportunity today. What we'd like you to do is, if you would like money to go to these Bibles, just write it on the envelope and how much you would like to go, and say for the Bibles or Bibles. Okay? Please do that on the envelope. And we're going to also pray for the offering at this time, and also pray for our nation, for our military. There's a lot of people who have gone into the military, not just in the wars in recent times, but in wars in the past, when the men and women came back and just were scarred, not only physically, but mentally and emotionally. The thing I want you to know, if that's you or if you know someone like that, our mighty God is a healer. He is a healer. And while we don't understand what you went through and what you saw and the things that you had to do, we have a God who loves you and who forgives no matter what you've done. We have stories in the Bible of a warrior by the name of David. He was an awesome warrior, and in the name of God and through the power of God killed thousands of the enemy single-handedly, and along with his army. And you know, I understand that we used to be called a Christian nation, and it's getting kind of hard to do that anymore. But let me tell you also this. I believe we are a Christian nation in the sense that there are a lot of Christians that believe our mighty God in this nation. We have a lot of people in this nation who don't believe in God, who haven't accepted God yet, and we call them pre-Christians because we're believing that they will come to know the Lord. But there's a lot right about our nation. And Diane's going to come and sing a song after a while about how, you know, the beauty of our nation. And it's a beautiful country. I have not been very many places, except for places where mankind has messed it up. I've not been many places in this country that haven't been beautiful. And God, this is where God has put me. I didn't ask to be born here. I was born here. I could have been born in Haiti. I could have been born in Nigeria. I could have been born anywhere in the world. Could have been born in Cambodia. You know, I've no choice of mine. So I thank God every day. When we pray over our meal, thank God I have something to eat. I have a place to live. I'm in a country where my neighbors care about me. You care about me, and I care about you. And we do things in this nation that I seriously doubt any other nation would do in helping those who are in need. And so it's, you know, it's, I guess I am proud to be an American. I'm not going to sing it right now, okay? I'll spare you that. But but can we just pray? God, thank you so much, each one of us, Lord, that have been born or live in this nation. We are grateful. We're grateful for those who have gone before, those who have died for in fighting for the freedoms that we hold dear today. And we are aware that everyone in our past or even in the future doesn't know you. But that's what we cry out for. Almighty God, when we sing, we ask for you to bless America. We're not asking you for more possessions. We are asking you, Almighty God, to bless us with a great awakening. That you would awaken hearts and lives, Lord, to their need of you, and that you stand with arms open wide to receive any who will call out to you. You will not turn anyone away. And you're a God who forgives. And we ask you today to forgive us of our sins as a nation. Forgive us of our sins, Lord, as individuals. And we thank you, Almighty God, that your word says that you're faithful and just, and you forgive us. And so we're forgiven. Lord, I pray for any today who have called out to you or will call out to you today. Lord, just help them to know that you receive them and you accept them. God, we pray for the wounds that some of our men and women come home with, some physical, some deeper than physical. God, we pray that you would heal them in the name of Jesus. Pray, oh God, that they would find you. We pray, Almighty God, that they would find that there is forgiveness, there is cleansing, and there is health in knowing you. Lord, now as we give in this offering, we ask your blessing upon it. We ask your blessing upon the Bibles that we will be able to give. Put your anointing, oh God, is already on your word. And we ask, Lord, that it would bring about the drawing in of many souls into your kingdom. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Go ahead, gentlemen. Please come and receive our offering. It's good to see you all here today. And I know some of you came just to celebrate because you're veterans or with veterans or dedicating a baby. And we're so glad that you're here. We ask Diane if she would come now and sing for us. Not going to say anything more. So my lips are sealed. Oh, I'm sorry. I can get your mic. I got it.
Dream that sea.